Hello.
So this is an attempt to make a perfect HHO bubbler based on my previous experience of making perfect bongs. Well, let's not go into that. What you see here is base of water filter. I got this for really cheap because shop was closing down. After many months of thinking about how I would close this big hole, I decided to try to weld some piece of plastic here. I don't have any experience or any good experience with welding plastic, so I'm trying this and it will fail later on, but I'm still trying. And basically this is the concept of this bubbler. So the idea is that we have two ports. One port is connected to the stainless steel tube and it will go right to the bottom of this filter. And the filter will be flipped upside down, so it will be basically the top of the filter now. Let's say top of the bubbler. Second port is connected to the base of the filter and now it's sealed with this plastic piece. I mean the piece that I welded. Now through this welded piece a lot of holes has to be punched or drilled or whatever you have by hand. I would recommend to make holes with diameter about 0.5 millimeters or so. Doing it the way that I did it makes hard to control the diameter of the holes, and it's always better to make less holes than more. And in my case I made too many, I think. If it's done right, it should be much quieter and the top of the water level should be much more calm. I think it will be very stupid if I compare this to the laminar flow, but instead of denser liquid flowing in less dense liquid, now we are flowing less dense liquid in more dense liquid. Basically air in the water. However, air is forming bubbles, so this is totally not laminar flow, so forget about it. Also, because we have such a big chamber at the base of this bubbler, the operation of this bubbler is not really quiet, so I'm definitely not satisfied. Also, these holes are definitely too large and there are too many of them. The bubbles should be not bigger than 3 millimeters in diameter. So yes, you can try to use air stones, but even then you will have a localized bubble generation basically. Or you can try to make your own air stone from epoxy and some sand or some other technique, but that is quite tricky, and also if you do not have some kind of manifold, there will be places where a lot of bubbles will be produced, but there will be some places where no bubbles will be produced. Okay, so now we are running from our HHO generator. So the purpose of the bubbler is to contain possible explosions. These explosions aren't particularly strong or whatever, but you really want to minimize the amount of HHO gas that will explode. Okay, now it's time for some explosions. You see that this bubbler likes to jump quite a lot when it explodes. I mean, wouldn't you? To minimize this effect, I'm going to preload this assembly with some wire. I would put there an O-ring if I had one, but I do not. Also, notice that after this second explosion, the sealing lid with the holes is now loose. Okay, so let's try this now. Well, there is a little tiny bit improvement, isn't it? Also, I captured the moment of explosion with my high-speed potato vision. Unfortunately, it's only 240 frames per second, but it would be absolutely perfect to have a really high-speed and high-resolution footage of this. Well, I hope this will help you to build your own bubbler much safer and more efficient. So, thanks for watching.